Here we have the green roof. But what I want to do is take you back and explain how we got to this stage. Today we have the green roof project. The size of the green roof is approximately 20 by 26. And what we're going to be showing you today is the stages. The first stage that we're going to get into is putting down the root barrier. But before we do that, we're going to be blowing and cleaning off the entire surface. You'll also see that there's no special preparations for the roof. It's a torch applied waterproofing that has been put down. And then you'll see the stages as we go on. Showing here in this clip is the actual waterproofing on the deck. As you can see here, again, nothing special has been done. It's a torch applied waterproofing on top of the deck. It's been swept, it's been cleaned, and it's been blown dry, or blown to get off any debris that's on top of it. And from this point, we're going to put down our root barrier. What we're doing right now is rolling out the root barrier. The root barrier is a polyethylene membrane. Typically, the minimum will be 10 mil. Here's the drain spout, and what we're doing now is cutting the opening for the drain spout. Typically, what you could do is just a cross section, and then you push it down. Once we've cut the X, what we're going to do is now cut around the drain pipe, nice and tight, all the way around. Be sure not to cut into the waterproofing membrane below. When cutting the root barrier, be sure that you leave enough overlap so that you can actually cover and tuck it underneath the parapet so that you've covered the actual waterproofing. So what we have here is the Casilla-Durkin Delta MS-20. MS-20 means, the 20 means 20 millimeter dimple height. And as you can see, they're large cones and they're specifically designed for water retention, so the cups do fill in with water. What we have here is perforations through the MS-20. These perforations are designed to allow water to flow through in case of overflow or too much rain. The MS-20 perforated comes in 2 meter by 20. And what I'm going to do now is I'm going to lay the product down and roll it out and begin to install the base to the green roof. So now that we have the MS-20 perforated down on top of the root barrier, we're going to roll out the product. And as you can see, I can stand directly on top of it without affecting any of the dimple configurations. When you come to the end of a roll and you have to start another roll, all you have to do is overlap the MS-20 by 2 dimples, as I'm showing right here. You lay the product down. We've just finished laying down the MS-20, and now the next stage, what we're going to do is put down a geosynthetic fabric. The reason why we're going to put down the geosynthetic fabric is because we want to maintain the cups free from the growing medium, so that they can fill up with water, but they're not going to be filled up with the growing medium. What we recommend to use is a geosynthetic with a minimum of 4 ounces per square yard. The reason why we chose a 4-ounce fabric is because we want to ensure that you have proper drainage
so that the soil particles from the growing medium do not clog up the fabric.
What we're showing here is the assembly of the MS-20 and the geosynthetic that's going to be on top. And the reason why we have brought it to this point right here is to protect and make sure that any stone will come right at this point, but any soil or growing medium does not get in behind and actually clog up the air gap. So this is the reason why we actually put it at this point and all the way up to where the root barrier is. So what we're going to do now is cut out our drain on top of the geosynthetic. What we're going to do is basically cut an X, which I've already pre-done. I'm going to push the fabric down. And for simplicity, we're going to take the fabric and tuck it underneath, just like so. And then around the drain, what's going to happen is you're going to install your stone. So we want to make sure, again, by having the geosynthetic here and the stone all the way around, what we want to make sure is that the soil from the particles from the growing medium do not come in and clog the drain. What I've just done now is put a little bit of the gravel rock that's going to go all the way around the outer edges. I just put a little bit now down just to hold the fabric so it doesn't blow away. So what I'm showing here is the river stone around the drain. But below the river stone, we have the geosynthetic, we have the MS-20, and we have the root barrier. Again, the idea behind the river stone is to make sure that the roots from the plants going to be planted today are not going to come in and clog up the drain. So as you can see, I'm going to stop here, and I'm going to go over the steps which we did before. We began with the waterproof deck. Then from the deck we put the root barrier, and the root barrier was a 10 mil polyethylene sheet that came up and underneath the parapet. Then from there we put the geosynthetic on top, we put the MS-20 on top of the root barrier, and the MS-20 finished right at the corner. And then on top of that we put our geosynthetic, which we have right now, that has come in and up to protect any soil particles from getting in behind, or growing medium particles from getting in behind. Then to protect the edges so that the roots from the plants do not come up and over, we put a bed of river stone. And typically you're going to go 14 inches from the parapet out, and it's sloped towards it, because now we're going to have the growing medium placed in this area. So now what I'm going to do is I'm going to just take buckets of river stone and basically lay them in, just like so. You always want to cover this area, you always want to maintain this covered in such a way so the UV does not go after and destroy the geosynthetic or the root barrier that's in behind.